I'm curious, has your legacy found you? I think it's possible that a legacy, the story, the project, the contributions that you would like to make actually find you, but often it sort of passes you by and you don't notice it, you don't grab it and bring it into yourself thinking, oh no, I've got to go through all this planning and searching and researching and attempting to figure out what it is, when in fact it actually showed up, sort of like knocked on the door and said hello, but you opened the door, didn't see anything, and sort of closed the door and walked away again. And I'm hoping that metaphor works for you. Hi, Dr. Stephen Hobbs here from the WELLth Movement. And I'm very interested in legacy, and it's one of the main thrusts of the WELLth Movement, which I am the founder of. And I wanted to just share a bit of a story with you about how legacy found me as a way to prompt you to take a look at when that door is knocked, or maybe when the wind blows through and you catch a sense of something is becoming present for you, that actually your legacy is attempting to say hello. So for me, one of the areas of my life that I've always enjoyed was the work of a facilitative mentor. And I became really great at that practice and using the concepts associated with it, much more than I could have with like an instructive coach. I've not called myself a coach in any measure, or said I'm gonna put out a shingle that says coach, but I am putting it out for mentor, and I have used it a lot of times in my workplace related work. When I was working for different kind of companies, when I was doing my own consulting work, and certainly when I was doing some of my professorial work and instructing, I was using it quite a bit. But what was interesting about it is that I've always known that I've enjoyed it, but I didn't know at that point in time that legacy was actually the sort of first step, or that doorstep to the door, so to speak. And when it actually knocked on my door and the word legacy popped in when I opened the door, I made this connection as that facilitative mentoring and legacy were connected. And then what that did was it prompted me to go, well, what is legacy? And that's when I came up with the definition, which is it's the useful what's that you gift others so that they might learn something, or they can learn something from your lived experience. And the useful what's I'm referring to is time, effort, and money. How you put those into action and how you express yourself and how you demonstrate the actions that you're taking. There is a story of legacy, the project that goes with that, the contributions that you're making. And a lot of the videos that are on the Wealth Learning TV channel now have to deal with legacy, and I would certainly encourage you to look through the other ones that are there and see if they prompt you to look at your legacy a little bit more. But back to the story. So once I started actually sort of looking at and moving the word around and attempting to figure out what it meant to me, what meaning would I give to it now that I've named it, called legacy, what did it mean to me? And having defined it, I started to realize that it's just a wonderful, wonderful topic that I can weave into my life, I can celebrate into my life, and it fits with where I'm going, especially now that I am well past 55 plus, and I'm starting to look at a curtain of 70, and what might legacy mean for me? And that's when I started to say, I think there's something here. It has found me. Now what am I going to do with it? And one of the key phrases that popped up for me was, is it about leave a legacy or live from your legacy? And I've decided it's to live from your legacy. And in that way, you're actually enjoying your legacy as you are living it. So it forms your life, your leadership, the legal aspects of your life, the literacy aspects of what it is that you've learned and you can share, and certainly something I call Loverage, It's leverage. Take the first E and turn it to O and you get leverage. So I'll be talking more about how to leverage and what that means in one's life from a legacy point of view. And the other four areas that I've just mentioned, but I just wanted to make some sense of, well, there's quite a wide sense of what legacy means for each of us. And if we're living from our legacy, and when I'm working with you, it'd be living from your legacy, and I'm guiding you to get there, then I think there's lots that can unfold. And that's why the pillars, the tenets, are values, challenge, project, story, and contributions. Those are the basic tenets that we use to be able to figure out what legacy is, to actually decode it. That's why I've called it legacy decoded. And I think that there's a lot there for you to actually look at and to weave it into your own life. I'm reaching out to those who are like 55 plus professionals, quasi-professionals, creatives, and coaches and mentors as well, to look at this legacy story and project and contributions that you have and find ways to inspire, enthuse, right, and give some sense of certainty to you around your legacy so that you can express it in how you be, have, and do each day. So with that, I'm going to encourage you to certainly comment, like, share around this video, ring the bell, because if we start to share with one another insights about what you pick up from these videos, it's very helpful for all of us to be able to learn from each other, because legacy is strengthened when we share it. And one of the things that we'll be doing is I'm creating a program called Etchings in Sand. And there is lake sand, river sand, and ocean sand. And depending on where your legacy is calling you to do it, then it might be local and what I call lake sand, or it might be something that's moving regional, national, and interregional. I call that river. And then maybe there's something that you're wanting to do for the planet as a whole. I call that ocean sand. And along the way, if we wanted to work on some eco-related projects, eco-region projects, then there are ways that I can support you because it's part of my legacy story. And I'll put a link to the five areas, the five projects, legacy projects that I'm working on, and you can get a sense of it. Over time, I'll be sharing more with you about those different projects, naming them, introducing you to the people that are involved as well. So there's lots and lots of things that are unfolding here, but my encouragement with this video is, has legacy found you? That's the question. Has it knocked on your door? Has it shown up with the wind blowing through the trees? Has someone said something to you at an evening meal? Has something popped up on television? Has there been some people who've been talking to you, even in the supermarket, and all of a sudden they say something and you just sort of, that's kind of interesting. And then you sort of, all of these you let go, or you don't open the door, or you just let it all pass by, when in fact, legacy was there to find you. And if you pay attention and see the intention associated with that legacy, the awareness that you gather from that is, it's beautiful. It deepens and enriches your life. And that's what I would encourage for all of you, is to find that legacy. And for each one of you, there is a legacy, but then how might we share those legacies? That would be fun. And that's where we can go together. But I am here to help you out individually as well. So let's see what we can do. Again, I just remind you, subscribe, comment, like, and share. And with that, take care.